this airplane fly. I'm telling you, it flies on the plane, not on the engine. And the skill that Ken is demonstrating cannot be understated. Sure, he's a comedian. Everybody loves to watch Ken's Jelly Belly fly. But the skill cannot be unrecognized. I mean, look at this. All the way around, a big barrel roll right there. If you're a pilot, you know how hard this is in a high-wing training airplane like an Interstate Cadet. This thing, though, it dances when Ken is at the helm. Little slow roll, all, of course, flown on the wing. I keep saying that. What does that mean, fly on the wing? It means that he has to use the energy that he has when he climbs up. He can dive back out. That's the only way he gets in the airspace. See? Look at that. Like a roller coaster. He's got to be going downhill to build that energy up. Kent, though, he knows how to do this. He uses the entire stage in front of him. That wingtip smoke, just there is an exclamation point. Jelly Belly, Fairfield, California. Family-owned business. Makes those great jelly bellies. We all have had about 1,000 of them today. I know Kent's been down the line. Check out this hesitation roll that he's doing. A 4-point hesitation roll for the Interstate Cadet. I don't know how it does it. Ken's going to give us a good look at the trees there. And if there's a bar ditch that a groundhog can run through, Ken will fly right through it too. He doesn't care. This guy has more fun when he flies. Look at that smile on his face. Can you see it from here? I can't. Diamondback smash. He's going to pull it back for a big loop. Look at this old Barnstormer loop. Could you imagine back in the day when the greats like Bebo Howell would do that? Hyper Cub, like a 40-something horsepower engine. Kent has twice that. This is practically a hot rod. Just look at this guy. Have fun. Barrel rolls and loops and old-fashioned aerobatics. The Barnstormer delights that Kent Pietsch brings to any air show. And those jelly bellies guaranteed to put a smile on the kiddos' faces. We just love watching Mr. Pietsch fly. Now here's something cool. He's been flying since about 1967. At the age of 16, he completed his first solo flight. Been an airline pilot. He's done it all, I'm telling you. Kent Pietsch, there isn't much he hadn't accomplished in the airplane world. He and his brother, the whole family fly. In air shows, including their father and their uncles, up there in Minot, North Dakota. Why not Minot, as he likes to say. Watching out on the left, and he comes back around, all the way around in that truck now, making his way to the runway. What is he going to do with the truck? You said he's going to land on the truck, Matt. Yeah, he's going to land on it. Watch it. Here it comes. Accelerating at the speed of smell up to about 60. Kent's going to park the airplane right on top of that pickup truck. Now he has to look out the side because we're bifocal, so that's why he's crabbing like that. All the way over his look. There he goes. He's got it. Going to bounce it down and move it up forward a little bit. What do you think, Chase? Going to get on that? Stories about flying, you know what I mean? I'd like to apologize to that lady that shared that last night, too, by the way, who was helping us out. Man, oh man. We were having a good time. Kent was telling stories about flying up there in Minot, you know. He said he could watch his dog, wanted to run away for a week, as he likes to say. Nothing up there. But Kent, when he breaks out his guitar, it becomes a good time, much like the strut top landing. Now he's got it really slow. You see that? He just hauled back on the stick. It's coming down like an elevator. Look at that. I'm telling you folks, the airmanship in Camp Beach demonstrates is just second to none. Now watch, he's going to speed the truck up just a bit. There we go. He's going to ease it right on top. Come on, Ken. I'm saying good things about you, but I'm running out. Let's go. Hurry it up, Ken. Pedal faster. There you go. Now you got it. Oh, he's wiggling. He's working hard to get it up there. Come on. Help him out, folks, down there on the right. Whoop. Let's see. He might get it this time. He's working really hard at it. I don't know. Yeah, didn't get it that time. We're bringing it back around. Give it one more pass. George, do we have time for one more attempt? One more attempt. We don't want to run out of time here. Those other jets want to fly, so let's see. Yes. Where is the bishop? We need the bishop back here to say a prayer for Kent to make this next landing. Let's see. All right, the truck's speeding back up. And the Jelly Bellies are going to do their job this time, I think. Need some more of those, by the way. We have the kids' packs. How many of you have Jelly Bellies out here? Have you gotten a few of them for Mr. Kent? Oh, aren't they great for kids' packs? The Jelly Belly airplane, an icon in our business. When you see that little yellow airplane with all those jelly bellies on it, you know you're about to get a treat. Kent Beach loves to hand them out if you get a chance to see them. Grab some jelly beans. Now we're going to turn the truck around. I have a really good feeling about this. The wind on our wind speed meter now showing, well, around 8 knots. Nope, now it's adjusting a little bit, but we'll see. I think he's going to get it this time. Ken certainly now for his good luck pass. I don't know, Rose, is he going to get it this time? What do you think? It's the third attempt. I think he's going to get it. I think it's a safe bet. Pretty good bet. Let's see. The pedal's going back down on his 20-year-old pickup truck there in North Dakota. Think he's got more kill marks on it than Butch O'Hara did from World War II. Watch it now as it comes out a little bit lower. There we go. Oh, he's got it this time. Oh, yeah, there we go. Now it's got it in the wheel box. Oh, come on, Kit. Taking us into a liner now. Oh, there we go. See it from here. Did he get it? No? Oh my goodness. Getting skunked today down there. When I said that, the truck had more kill marks than Mitchell here. I wasn't kidding. He hit like 8 deer with that truck, you know, a couple of muskrats. Yeah. Crazy. Well, let's see what happens now. Kent's got a few of them on there, but that wind today just really making it tough. But you can now say that you have seen Kent Pietsch land atop the pickup truck. An awesome job. We didn't want to try and actually put in the wheel chocks with this crazy wind today. He made the decision right there at the end just to get off of it. He said that wind was too much. But a nice job by our friend Kent Pietsch, who later in the performance will climb up high, really high, and turn the engine off, and he'll sail down, just glide it down in a beautiful aerobatic routine without his engine on. They call it a dead stick routine. And he does this because he wants you to understand that if an airplane loses its engine, it can still fly. I mean, it's a lot of people that are very afraid to fly. Kim is going to demonstrate this routine so you will know that an airplane can still fly even if it loses its engine. So a safety demonstration by Kim Pietsch later on.